I'm Dr. Sridhar Kalyanasundaram. Welcome to the series on vaccination. If you have not already subscribed, please do subscribe to continue following this. There are multiple videos on this channel for both parents and medical personnel, especially pediatricians and pediatric nurses. And there is multiple videos for neonatal trainees and neonatal nurses as well. I request you to go through the playlist so you will be able to segregate the information you want to get. And don't wait for the new videos, because there are more than 400 videos on the channel already, and you can review the videos which interest you. So in this video, I'll be discussing mainly about the BCG vaccine. The BCG vaccine, this is expansion bacillus calmette-guerin. It's a live attenuated vaccine for tuberculosis, and it's basically the BCG strain of the Mycobacterium bovis or bovine tuberculosis, which is attenuated in the lab. So this is one of the early vaccines after the cowpox vaccine. This is produced in 1921. Albert Calmette, a French physician and bacteriologist, and his colleague Camille Guerin, was a veterinarian. They subcultured the virulent strains of the tuberculosis bacillus. They noted a glycerin bile potato mixture grew bacilli that seemed less virulent, and then they subcultured on repeated basis 239 times during 13 years till they were convinced that this subculture will not cause a virulent form of the infection. So the vaccine was produced from that. They both moved to the Pasteur Institute, and they were involved in disseminating this vaccine information. It's very effective in preventing the serious childhood forms of tuberculosis if given under 12 months of age. So tuberculosis, meningitis, and miliary tuberculosis. It is effective in preventing pulmonary tuberculosis, but the effect is lesser. So you can say it's about 75% effective in preventing these two severe forms, and about 55 to 60% effective in reducing the pulmonary tuberculosis form. It can last in efficacy till the child is like 15 to 20 years old. If it is given in the newborn period, the claim is that it can be a lifelong protection as well. You might be interested in knowing that the BCG vaccine has been shown to reduce the effectiveness of COVID in some populations. So the BCG vaccine is usually administered by intradermal injection over the left deltoid. This is convention. You can give it on the left or right, but because we look for the scar as an evidence of the BCG vaccine, it's better to give it on the same side, on the left side. Whether it is given anywhere else, it's not been studied, so better not to give on the feet or the thigh or anywhere. Intradermal injections are tricky to give. You need to get a wheal formation of 5 mm or so. And it's very important that a trained person gives the correct dosage and optimal BCG vaccine. So the dose is 0.05 ml in babies under 1 month and 0.1 ml for older infants. The injected site usually shows no visible change apart from the immediate wheal, which goes down quickly. Subsequently, a papule develops after 2 to 3 weeks. Sometimes it takes 2 to 3 months for this papule to come up. And this increases to a size of 4 to 8 millimeter around this size by 5 to 6 weeks. The papule heals with ulceration and results in a scar after 6 to 12 weeks. So during this period, it can blister, it can break, it can blister, it can break 2-3 times. It's not contagious, it doesn't spread around. So you just need to clean and observe. You don't need to put antibiotic cream or powder there. The final scar is usually thin, and you will see it as a confirmation of the BCG vaccine. There is no treatment needed for this BCG reaction. Approximately 10% of the vaccine recipients do not develop a scar, and that does not mean the protection has not been achieved. So that is one of the reasons why we tell two nurses to review the injection site for the wheal, and if they have confirmed that the wheal has risen, if this scar doesn't come up, it doesn't matter. You can assume they are immune. However, if it is not documented, you may consider repeating the vaccine after 3 months. There are no details related to the efficacy, safety of other anatomic sites of administration, so giving in the buttocks, thighs, or even the feet is not recommended. The risk of BCG adenitis is low. It's 0.6%. Most of the time it self-resolves, but sometimes it may need surgical intervention. In an immunocompromised patient, it can lead to systemic illness. Some countries like the UK, they're screening for the severe combined immunodeficiency, which is one of the contraindications. So because the newborn screening result will come by 2 weeks or so, they recommend giving BCG at the end of the first month. So it's usually given at birth, and this I mentioned about the SCID in newborn screen, only in certain parts of the world. If it is not given at birth, it should be given preferably within 3 months of age. If you are living in an endemic area where the risk of exposure to tuberculosis is high, or you are suspecting that this baby may have come in contact with maybe a carer or a nanny who has tuberculosis, it's better to give the tuberculin before the repeat vaccine is given. However, if there is no such contact, you may give the vaccine repeat straight away. So BCG is not recommended after 12 months of age, because the protection provided is variable and it's less certain. So if you have not given under 1 year of age, you don't need to consider BCG if you have missed it for any reason. If the infant does not have a scar and you cannot determine whether the dose has been given, you can repeat, and in the circumstance of exposure, of high risk of exposure, you can give tuberculin. Otherwise, you can give without the tuberculin as well. So this is the basic information about BCG. I hope this is useful. Please do share. Thank you.